showing you the transverse section of a 29 years old Peres female. This is the left ovary. This is the left ovary. We can see the follicles developing. This is the uterus. And this is the urinary bladder. This is the urinary bladder in longitudinal section. This is the longitudinal section of the uterus. And the uterus is normal in size, no myometrial mass is seen. And endometrial canal, it measures 10.5 into 4.2. This is the endometrial lining, this one. It's intact, central, clear. Measures approximately 5.1 in early proliferative phase. Now there is a small amount of fluid here, this one, small amount of fluid seen in the cul-de-sac. Now when I move the probe towards the region of the left and right adnexa, because we did see that the ovary on the left side is normal, and here I see a multi-septated cystic mass that extends from the region of the right adnexa up to the, here you see, anterior of the uterus. See, this is all cyst, measures approximately 12.3 by 4.2, with uterus measuring 10.6 by 4.2 centimeters. Now in this cyst, which is clear internally of any, no echoes are seen, no calcification seen, no debris and no septa or any solid element seen, though these septas are seen, yes. I said no septa. These are septas within this cyst. And when I move the probe transversely, it remains there. Now you see, this is a portion of the uterus that you are seeing, otherwise this is all cyst, a large cyst. So with the again septa, this is a septa. So here you see it here. Now this is the same cyst which is when it's beginning from the left region of the left right adnexa, it gives a multilocality appearance, though this is a complete cyst, and this is the cyst, another cyst. So this is a multiseptatic ovarian cyst on the right side, extending extending medially anterior to the urinary bladder. This is the urinary bladder, and as I move the probe anteriorly, here it comes. So it extends anterior to the urinary bladder in the midline, and here you will see these are the vessels. These are the iliac vessels. So these are iliac vessels, and there is no evidence of any flow within the of vessels within this cystic area. Well, its wall does contain some echoes. See, the wall is giving some echoes. So the wall has vascularity. You see, this is the wall. I am labeling the septa as a wall. This is the septa, and this is the arterial flow through the septa here, and this is again see this is the septa, thick septa, and we can see arterial blood in this region. Again, you see in this septa, again, there is, this is the septa and we see arterial blood. This is the septa and we see venous blood in this septa. Now you see that in this region, these are thick septas with flow within their walls, both arterial as well as. Now this is nothing but this is a blood vessel through the thick septas. So my first impression will be either a multi-septated large ovarian cyst with septations, or number two will be cyst of Morgagni in the pelvic region, as these are the ideal vessels. Interest, the pathology, which is multi-septated, thick septas, thin septas, with flow within these septas, as you can see in this case here. So this is our case for today. Thank you very much.